We're happy to welcome our parishioners and guests to St. Joseph's as we celebrate the 19th Sunday in Ordinary Time. These are today's announcements. Mass this Monday, August 10th, will be moved to 8 a.m. There will be no noon Mass due to a staff planning meeting. The Catholic Daughters will be having a potluck picnic this Monday, August 10th, at 6:30 p.m. at Roosevelt Park. Dinnerware will be provided. Please bring your own beverage. In case of inclement weather, the picnic will be canceled. Grief Share will meet this Wednesday, August 12th, at 6:30 p.m. in the Parish Center. Father Wilhelm has obtained furniture from a motel in Fargo and needs help moving it here to St. Joseph's Closet. We need a big truck or trailer and maybe several of them to get the job done. He's also in need of 6 to 8 able-bodied men to help move the furniture both from the motel in Fargo and into a storage shed in Devil's Lake. Please contact the parish office and leave your name and what you can do to help. He will feed you for the day and pay all gas expenses. The tentative date is set for the second or third week of August. Time to be determined. Thank you for your generosity. Are you feeling a tug on your heart to spend more time concentrating exclusively on Jesus present before us and allow him to look back on you with love? An adorer is needed for Monday evenings at 6 p.m. Please contact Deacon Ken for more information. Father Fow is the celebrant for this Mass, and I am Joanne Kitchens, your lector. Let us prepare our hearts to celebrate Holy Mass.
Enter into the mystery of this holy universe. other to God, whom, taught by the Holy Spirit, we dare to call our Father. Bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the first book of Kings. At the mountain of God, Horeb, Elijah came to a cave where he took shelter. Then the Lord said to him, "Go outside and stand on the mountain before the Lord. The Lord will be passing by." A strong and heavy wind was rending the mountains and crushing rocks before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind. After the wind, there was an earthquake. But the Lord was not in the earthquake. After the earthquake, there was a fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. After the fire, there was a tiny whispering sound. When he heard this, Elijah hid his face in his cloak and went and stood at the entrance of the cave. The word of the Lord. The response: Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. I will hear what God proclaims, the Lord, for he proclaims peace. Near indeed is his salvation to those who fear him, glory dwelling in our land. Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. Kindness and truth shall meet. Justice and peace shall kiss. Truth shall spring out of the earth, and justice shall look down from heaven. Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. The Lord himself will give his benefits. Our land shall yield its increase. Justice shall walk before him and prepare the way of his steps. Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I speak the truth in Christ. I do not lie. My conscience joins with the Holy Spirit in bearing me witness that I have great sorrow and constant anguish in my heart. For I could wish that I myself were accursed and cut off from Christ for the sake of my own people, my kindred according to the flesh. They are Israelites. Theirs the adoption, the glory, the covenants, the giving of the law, the worship, and the promises. Theirs the patriarchs, and from them, according to the flesh, is the Christ, who is over all. God blessed forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia,
alleluia. I wait for the Lord, my soul waits for his word. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. After he had fed the people, Jesus made the disciples get into a boat and precede him to the other side while he dismissed the crowds. After doing so, he went up on the mountain by himself to pray. And when it was evening, he was there alone. Meanwhile, the boat, already a few miles offshore, was being tossed about by the waves, for the wind was against it. During the fourth watch of the night, he came toward them walking on the sea. When the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified. "It is a ghost," they said, and they cried out in fear. At once Jesus spoke to them, "Take courage, it is I, do not be afraid." Peter said to him in reply, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." He said, "Come." Peter got out of the boat and began to walk on the water toward Jesus. But when he saw how strong the wind was, he became frightened, and beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately Jesus stretched out his hand and caught Peter and said to him, "O you of little faith, why did you doubt?" After they got into the boat, the wind died down. Those who were in the boat did him homage, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord. In today's gospel, Peter shows both his impulsiveness and his inconsistency, two characteristics that make him easy to relate to. It's around 3 o'clock in the morning as the apostles battle against a stormy sea, and Jesus comes walking across the lake towards the boat. The apostles are scared stiff. They think they are seeing a ghost. Even Jesus' reassurance doesn't calm their fears. So Peter takes the matter into his own hands and challenges the ghost to do something that only Christ could do, enable him to walk on the stormy water. And he does, for a few steps. But then Peter takes his eyes off Christ. He looks around at the waves and the storm, and he starts to sink. As long as Peter kept his eyes on Christ, he was able to walk unhindered through the stormy sea. As soon as he let his eyes wander away from Christ to examine the intimidating waves, he began to sink. Just so, as we strive to make our way through the stormy temptations and challenges of life in a fallen world, only focusing on Christ can keep us afloat. Christ is always close to us in our storms, asking us to believe in him. In his words to Peter, slightly with disappointment, we see how much he longs for us to trust in him. "Why did you doubt?" As soon as Jesus steps into the boat, the storm gives way to peace and calm. Christ wants to be our peace, our strength, and the solution to life's troubles. St. Peter didn't learn this lesson right away, but he learned it well as he put it in his first letter, 1 Peter 5:7. "Cast all your anxieties on him, Christ, for he cares about you." Listen to this quote from St. Augustine. "If I try by myself to swim across the ocean of this world, the waves will certainly engulf me. In order to survive, I must climb aboard a ship made of wood. This wood is the cross of Christ. Of course, even on board the ship, there will be dangerous temptations and perils of the sea of this world. But God will help me remain on board the ship and arrive safely at the harbor to eternal life." Isn't that what Jesus is trying to teach us today through St. Matthew's Gospel? I want to repeat that quote again from St. Augustine. "If I try by myself to swim across the ocean of this world, the waves will certainly engulf me. In order to survive, I must climb aboard a ship made of wood. This wood is the cross of Christ. Of course, even on board the ship, there will be dangerous temptations and perils from the sea of this world. But God will help me remain on board the ship and arrive safely at the harbor of eternal life. By taking on the wood of the cross, he will help you and I remain on board safely to eternal life. Like St. Peter, we all need to learn that there is a limit to what we can do by the means of our natural abilities. But there is no limit to what God can do in us and through us if we truly trust and abandon ourselves to his will. The great spiritual writer Henry Nouwen wrote a little story describing this truth. It goes like this. Once upon a time, there was a little river that said, "I can become a big river." It worked hard to get big, but in the process encountered a huge rock. "I won't let this rock stop me," the river said, and the little river pushed and pushed until it finally made its way around the rock. Next, the river encountered a mountain. "I won't let this mountain stop me," the river said, and the little river pushed and pushed until it finally carved a canyon through the mountain. The river, now large and powerful, finally arrived at the edge of a vast desert. "I won't let this desert stop me," the river said. But as the river pushed and pushed its way across the desert, the hot sand began soaking up its water until only a few puddles remained. The river was quiet. Then the river heard a voice from above. "My child, stop pushing. It's time to surrender. Let me lift you up. Let me take you over." The river said, "Here I am." The sun then lifted the river up and turned it into a huge cloud. And the wind carried the river across the desert and let the rain down on the hills and the valleys of the faraway fields, making them fruitful and rich. If we stay focused on Christ, having more faith in him than ourselves, obeying his will, even when it's hard, no obstacle will be too much for us, and he will make our lives more fruitful than we could ever imagine. But how can we do this in this 21st century and keep focusing on Christ? We won't be able to look into Jesus' physical eyes as Peter did until Judgment Day. But in the meantime, we can still focus our eyes on Christ in three ways. First, we can spend time in prayer in the presence of the Eucharist. The Eucharist is the real presence of Christ, body, blood, soul, and divinity under the appearance of bread. This presence is an ongoing miracle, a true amazing gift of God's love that we always have with us right here in the tabernacle, right next to the sanctuary light, whose living flame reminds us of Christ's living presence in the sacrament. Coming to make a short visit to the Eucharist, or coming to adore him in a longer visit, this is one sure way to keep our gaze fixed on the Lord. We are so blessed to have this opportunity here in our own parish with our Adoration Chapel located right behind me. Take a look in the bulletin this week and ask yourself if Jesus is calling you to come and visit him, as we are in need of someone to spend time with him on Monday from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. Second, we can always find Christ in the Holy Scriptures. The Bible is a unique book. It is inspired by God. When we read it with faith, seeking to find Christ there, he reveals himself to us. The Catechism quotes St. Jerome on this point, saying, "Ignorance of Scripture is ignorance of Christ." It is the immature and irresponsible Christian who doesn't take some time each day, even if only a few minutes, to gaze upon Christ by reading the Bible. And thirdly, we can gaze upon Christ by serving our brothers and sisters in need. Jesus himself said, "Whatever we do for our neighbors, we do for him. He is present in them. There are so many in need and so few to help. Our very own Knights of Columbus, Catholic Daughters, and St. Vincent de Paul in our parish are out there working in one way or another. If you feel Jesus calling you, trust in him and help in any way you feel called." Today, as Christ through this Mass comes to us once again in the stormy seas of our concerns, worries, and weaknesses, let's welcome him with strong faith, and let's promise him to keep welcoming him, to keep gazing upon him every single day.
Please join now as we pray our Nicene Creed together. If you need the words, they are on the inside cover of your missalette. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection and the life of the world to come. We are confident that God hears our prayers, and so we ask God to answer our needs, the needs of the entire world.
For Pope Francis and his intention for the month of August, for all those who work and live from the sea among their sailors, fishermen, and families, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all in medical care and the medical sciences, may God continue to give them the knowledge, skills, and compassion to care for the sick and seek ways to end this pandemic. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the newly ordained priests of the Diocese of Fargo, Fathers Riley Durkin, Jared Grossman, and Eric Seitz, may God fill them with the joy of the Catholic priesthood and guide them throughout their ministry. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our farmers, ranchers, and all who work in agriculture, may they be protected from all harm and be granted the proper weather for a bountiful harvest. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving for those who have donated to the St. Mary's Chapel and Learning Resource Addition to our St. Joseph Catholic School and Religious Education Center, and that we may be able to finish this project by the generosity of our people and alumni. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for Gemma June Swan, Creed Jacob Wolf Burdick, William Richard Mertens, Irie King Littlewood, and Novelli Hope Littlewind were baptized this weekend. May the Holy Spirit lead them throughout their lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in our parish, especially Madeline Kurtz, Richard Berg, and Catherine Weber, and for the deceased family of Joe and Kathleen Ann Connor, for whom this holy mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Gracious God, we praise you and thank you for hearing our prayers, answering all of us in our needs. May we continue to be faithful to your Son, Jesus Christ, whom you sent to be our Savior and Redeemer. We ask all this through Christ our Lord. Please be seated. Blessed are you, fruit of the vine, work of your name, Sisters and brothers, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church. For in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim, "Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest." You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a perfect sacrifice, pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. And may this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, John, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you've gained for your own. And listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There, we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. We stand with Christ, and at our Savior's command, formed by his divine teaching, we now dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And with your spirit. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us your peace. Behold, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ. 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 Body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. 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 Body of Christ. The 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 body of Christ. Body of Christ. The 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 body of Christ. 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 The body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Thank you.
The bread that I will give, says the Lord, is my flesh for the life of the world. Let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth through Christ our Lord. Amen. I wish all of you, in the name of our parish and the priests of our parish and Deacon Ken here, a wonderful work that he does here in your parish, preaching and doing so many things for our parish as well. So we wish you all a blessed week. And one thing, this coming Saturday, August the 15th, some of you should remember that date. It's the Feast of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary, when Mary was taken by God into heaven because of her special place that she had in the life of Christians and of the church. So it's a holy day, but not a holy day of obligation. So, but there will be Mass that Saturday morning at 8:30 here in the parish. So if you can't attend the Mass, please pray the rosary that day and maybe throughout the week in preparation for the Blessed Feast of Mary. We will conclude by praying together. I think it would be nice for us to pray today, the Memorare. It's in the back of your missalette if you need it, but anticipating the Feast of the Assumption. Pray with me. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to your protection, implored your help, or sought your intercession was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, I fly unto you, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother. To you I come, before you I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word Incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in your mercy, hear and answer me. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Were you rescued?